students, welcome to my class. Today we'll be dealing with nursing care plan. So nursing care plan is one of the heart of nursing. So without nursing care plan, there is no nursing. So everywhere in our clinical area and also in exams, we have to write the nursing care plan. So in the recent classes, we have read about the respiratory conditions. So today I'll be dealing with the nursing care plan related to the respiratory disorder. First diagnosis you make is ineffective airway clearance related to increased mucus plug impaction, secondary to inflammation, fibrosis, leading to bronchoconstriction as evidenced by abnormal respiratory sounds. Okay, so whenever there is, so only if the airway is clear, then only patient will get oxygen. So first priority is oxygen, and we have to clear the airway. So the airway can be obstructed due to mucus plug or any inflammation and fibrosis, which can cause bronchoconstriction. This you can identify by the abnormal respiratory sound. So the subjective data, patient may complain of cough, chest pain, shortness of breath or sore throat or nasal congestion. So this all reveals that there is so many secretions accumulated inside the lungs or the respiratory tract. And objective data, so you can do a sputum analysis, so you can see the color and consistency. So with that you can identify whether the what type of sputum, whether it is infected or infected or not, and the respiratory rate will be increased or decreased. So certain time patient may show tachypnea or a bradypnea. And breath sounds, you can hear wheezing or ronchi, so these are abnormal sounds. And chest x-ray, you can see consolidation of the lungs, which means there is accumulation of secretion inside the respiratory tract. Okay, the goal or objective is to improve the mucus clearance and aid in normal breathing. So when the secretion is clear, the patient can breathe properly. And so first you have to monitor vital signs, so in that you can see the respiratory rate is deranged or decreased or increased. So with that you can identify what is the problem. Okay, and then Fowler's positioning. So in this position, the diaphragm will come down, so patient will have enough place to breathe. And steam inhalation, so this again it will liquefy the mucus and send it outside. Oxygen therapy, again to help in breathing. And nebulizer therapy, again it will make the secretions loose and can come out. And chest physiotherapy helps to mobilize the secretions from the lower area of the lungs and it can be pushed outside by coughing. And you have to advise the person to take more of oral fluids, so these can again loosen the thick secretions and they can bring the secretions out. And anticholinergics are given. So anticholinergic main function is to remove the secretions, and expectorants, they also will expel out the secretions. And in reassurance and psychological support will be given. So when the person's secretion is obstructing the throat, patient will feel like suffocating and choking, and he or she may be fear about death, etc. So we have to provide reassurance and psychological support. So in evaluation, so you have to see whether the airway is cleared and patient breath sounds are returned to normal and patient had any decrease in secretions. Next diagnosis is ineffective breathing pattern related to bronchoconstriction. So bronchoconstriction will happen in case of bronchitis or any COPD, and trapping of air within the lungs. So this is occurs in case of emphysema. There is dilatation of the bronchus and the air gets trapped inside. So within the lungs, as evidenced by increased effort for breathing. Subjective data will be patient will have cough, shortness of breath, and patient will show chest pain and choking sensation in the throat, labored breathing. So subjective data is what the patient complains. So these all patient may complain. So in objective data means we observe the respiratory rate may be increased or decreased according to the condition of person. And use of accessory muscles of breathing. So whenever there is difficulty in breathing, patient's neck muscles and diaphragmatic muscles will go up and down, that you can identify. That is use of accessory muscles of breathing. And barrel chest. So barrel chest is the AP diameter of the chest will be increased. Next is chest retraction. So that is the ribs all will be retracting when the patient is taking breathing. So you can see the flaring of the rib bone,
which means patient is having difficulty to breathe. And palpation will show tactile or vocal fremitus. Fremitus is when the person is having breathing difficulty, the words will be coming like a wave. Okay, so like that, some wave like sound will come, that is called fremitus. so that you can see when you palpate the lungs. And percussion will show dull sounds, and auscultation will the sounds will be wheeze, ronchi, crackles, rails. So these all the abnormal sounds you can hear when patient is having breathing difficulty. And pulse oximetry will reveal decreased saturation, so there is no blood oxygen going to the blood due to obstruction. And chest x-ray will show again consolidation in the lungs. So these are the objective data you can identify. Our goal is to improve the breathing pattern and aid in respiration, so that is patient should have a normal respiration. So in intervention, first my vital signs will be monitored. So in this you can see respiratory rate is deranged. So this will show the baseline data. And Fowler positioning and comfort devices like cardiac table. So in Fowler's position, the diaphragm will come down, so patient will have extra space to breathe. And when you give cardiac table, patient can lean on the cardiac table and have his can take a nap on the cardiac table. And we have to provide well ventilated environment, so that oxygen will flow will be inside, so there will be a good flow of oxygen and patient can have little more oxygen to breathe. And next, oxygen therapy with mask or NIPP is non-invasive positive pressure ventilation and mechanical ventilator. So any of these measures according to the need of the patient and as per physician advice, we will start the oxygen therapy. So this will help in artificial breathing for the patient. And suctioning, nebulizer therapy, chest physiotherapy, this all will remove the secretion so that there will be extra space for oxygenation of the lungs. Again, inhaler therapy, so whenever there is sudden acute exacerbations of wheezing and other breathlessness, then inhaler therapy will help to relieve the immediate oxygen needs of the person. And advice to take adequate bed rest. So when the person is doing more activity, oxygen is needed for activity, so you have to tell the patient to take bed rest adequately and space work according to he has to take frequent work and frequent bed rest so that we can conserve the energy and prevent oxygen insufficiency. And bronchodilators, these will dilate the bronchus and thereby aid in breathing. And corticosteroids in case of inflammation and bronchoconstriction and fibrosis deposition, to relieve that they give corticosteroid. And all emergency equipments like intubation, tracheostomy and other procedures should be kept ready at the bedside of the patient, so that if any emergency arises, we can meet the oxygen needs of the person. So with these interventions, you can help the person to have a normal breathing pattern and the breath sounds will return to normal and he will have a decreased effort for breathing. Okay, the next diagnosis will be impaired gas exchange related to increased mucus plug accumulation and obstruction of the airways, secondary to inflammation and fibrosis of the airways. So gas exchange, the alveoli and the capillaries are exchanging gases, that is oxygen from the alveoli is going to the capillaries and from the capillaries carbon dioxide is exchanging to the alveoli. So when this diffusion is not taking place due to problem with the alveoli, that is alveoli is not oxygenated properly, or if there is any obstruction in the capillaries where the carbon dioxide is not eliminated, so patient will have impaired gas exchange. So the subjective data, again breathlessness, chest tightness, choking, suffocation. So patient will have air hunger, that is very air hunger is patient feels like he's not get oxygen and he's going to about to die, and he suffocates and very deeply gasps for breath, so that you can identify. And respiratory rate, again it can be increased or decreased. So in case even if there is a respiration, there will be shallow respiration. Shallow respiration means chest wall will move faster, but you cannot see effective respiration, so that oxygen cannot enter inside. Again, tactile vocal fremitus you can hear on palpation, dull sound on percussion, and auscultation will reveal abnormal respiratory sound. And here you can see use of accessory muscles for breathing, so that is lung is somehow trying to take the oxygen by using all the muscles. And decreased saturation levels, so that will be less than 90%, and ABG will be decreased. So in ABG you can see partial pressure of oxygen and saturation will be decreased, and partial pressure of carbon dioxide may be increased. And pursed-lipped breathing, so like person will cannot breathe normally through nose, he will be breathing like this in the mouth with the pursed lip, that is closed lips. And spirometry, so this is pulmonary function test. So here you can see decreased lung compliance. So in this you can see all the capacity of the lungs. So you can see the decreased compliance. And chest x-ray will reveal again consolidation and pulmonary infiltrates in the lungs. So goal is to improve the gas exchange and increase oxygenation in the blood. So mainly you have to improve the oxygenation. So first monitoring vital signs. So here you can see respiratory rate is decreased or increased, and the respiration, shallow respirations will be there. And steam inhalation, so this again will relieve the secretions and prevent the mucus plug impaction, so patient can, oxygen can enter inside. And nebulizer therapy, oxygen again to liquefy the secretion and remove secretion, oxygen therapy to meet the artificial respiration of person, and chest physiotherapy, breathing, cuffing exercise, these all will mobilize the secretions from the lower respiratory tract and it will remove secretions. And high Fowler's position, so high Fowler's position is 90 degree, the head end of the bed should be there, so this to increase the space for breathing. Inhaler therapy to prevent exacerbations. Postural drainage is done, so in this each segment of the lung will be tapped in different positions and then secretions will be brought outside by making the person to cough out, and this can help in clearing the airway. And bronchodilators to dilate the bronchus, so they cause smooth muscle relaxation so that the bronchus will be dilated and the oxygen can enter inside. And inhaled or oral or parenteral corticosteroids can be given, so these will treat the inflammation and prevent bronchoconstriction. So inhaled means they given the inhaler therapy or a nebulizer therapy, and oral will be given by mouth, and parenteral can be given by intramuscular or intravenous injections. So evaluation, you can see patient gas exchange will be improved as evidenced by normal respiration. Next diagnosis is ineffective tissue perfusion related to inadequate gas exchange between the alveoli and capillaries, secondary to thrombosis or emboli obstructing the pulmonary capillaries, or due to lack of elastic recoil of the alveoli resulting in obstructed airflow. So tissue perfusion is, so whenever there is no oxygen exchange in the alveoli and capillaries, then the blood will not have oxygen, so the tissues also will not receive the oxygen. So there can be ineffective tissue perfusion. So it can be due to some obstruction in pulmonary capillaries where the blood is not going to the pulmonary capillaries, or it can be lack of elastic recoil of alveoli. This can be due to emphysema or any obstruction inside the alveoli, so where the air is not going inside. Okay, so the again subjective data, you can see cough, shortness of breath, fatigue or malaise, that is tiredness because there is no oxygen in the tissues, and decreased exercise tolerance, again no oxygen to tissues, and patient may complain of cyanosis, that is color change in the skin, blue color change, so this is because absence of oxygen in blood. And objective data, so you can see respiratory rate decreased or increased, again wheezing sounds, ronchi breath sounds will be there, accessory muscles will be used for breathing, and pulse oximetry will show decreased saturation, and ABG analysis will show saturation decrease, partial pressure of oxygen decrease, partial pressure of carbon dioxide will be increased, so this means carbon dioxide is more in blood whereas oxygen is low. And mixed venous oxygen, so that is MVO2, this also will be decreased because arterial blood is also not having oxygen, so venous blood should be giving perfusion to the tissues, so we have to maintain venous oxygen more. So but in case of patients with ineffective tissue perfusion, there will be decrease. And chest x-ray, you can see consolidation of lungs, which means there is some obstruction or dilation of the bronchus, etc. And ventilation perfusion scan, so this can reveal the patient gas exchange is not there, there is some obstruction in the pulmonary capillaries. So the goal or objective is to improve tissue perfusion and increase the exercise tolerance of a person. So first you have to assess the skin of cyanosis, monitor vital signs and saturation level. So this will provide baseline data to, and also identify what procedure to be followed next. And oxygen therapy as needed, so to aid in respiration, and provide adequate rest periods between activities so that patient will not have tolerance to activity, and maintain intake output chart to identify associated causes and risk factors. So what is causing, if there is some bleeding or something, you can identify. And vasodilators like nitrates to improve the, they cause vasodilation and they increase the blood flow. And fibrinolytic therapy and anticoagulants, so these will dissolve the clot in case patient is having a pulmonary embolism or thrombosis. This can dissolve the clot. And bronchodilators, in case of obstruction in bronchus, they will dilate and increase oxygen flow to the lung. Then IV fluid therapy can be done in order to increase the fluid volume and thereby increase the blood flow. And chest with air therapy, breathing and coughing exercise, again to remove the secretions if they are any obstructing in the bronchial walls and thereby help in respiration. Again, inhaled oral parenteral corticosteroids, they will treat inflammation and thereby they relieve the airway obstruction so that patient oxygenation of lungs can occur. And evaluation, tissue perfusion status was improved as evidenced by decreased cyanosis and improved saturation levels. So this we will evaluate in the person. Next is fear and anxiety related to breathlessness and prognosis of the disease and surgical intervention. So that is, so when patient is having breathlessness, he may have anxiety, like death anxiety may be there. And prognosis, so he doesn't know whether his disease will be cured or what will be the prognosis. And surgical intervention is maybe patient may be planned for a tracheostomy or a intubation or a thoracentesis or any surgical intervention. So patient may have fear and anxiety. So in our subjective data, patient may complain of choking, suffocation, breathlessness. So these all will cause fear, and chest tightness, labored breathing, and fear about the disease and its prognosis. And they may have doubts regarding the surgical and invasive procedures. So objective data, you can see the facial grimace showing worried and air hunger. So patient is breathing very very shallow and he's breathing so fast and frequently verbalize about the health status. So he keeps on asking what about his health, what is his prognosis, and sometimes he cries and feels depressed. So this you can observe. And our goal is to relieve the fear and anxiety and promote a sense of well-being for the person, and monitor vital signs and also level of anxiety. So you can see how, whether the anxiety is very severe like death anxiety, and Fowler positioning, so that oxygen status will be improved and thereby breathing also will be improved. And oxygen therapy, again to provide artificial respirations for the person, and positive reinforcement by providing motivation to do healthy behaviors. Okay, so you have to teach them what all the healthy behaviors, like if patient had a complaint of smoking or something, you have to tell them to avoid smoking. Okay, so all in case if there is an occupational hazard, then you have to tell him to abstain from occupation area. So like that, you have to give some positive reinforcement so that he will relieve the fear, and tell the patient to take adequate rest so that it can conserve the energy and also it can decrease the oxygenal needs. And diversional therapy, again with the light music or any, according to the patient interest, you can divert him from the fear. And group therapy, so here all the patients with the same disease will be brought together, and they will, we have to give them counseling, and you can ask the, each person to talk with each other so that they, each patients will share their experience, feelings. So when they keep talking, their fear and anxiety may be relieved. And introduce to the client who or person who have already undergone the same surgery. Okay, so if he has fear regarding surgery, then you have to introduce the person who have already undergone surgery for the same disease and is doing well, so that patient will have confidence. Next, bronchodilators can be given to dilate the bronchus and thereby increase oxygenation to the lungs. And reassurance and psychological support will be provided to comfort the person. So with these measures, you can relieve the anxiety and fear of the person so that the person may have a positive feeling and he will verbalize the positive behaviors. Okay, next is ineffective thermoregulation, hyperthermia related to infiltration of neutrophils and inflammatory mediator secondary to pulmonary infection and invasive procedures. Okay, so any invasive procedure, and if the person is already having an infection, then the person may go for fever. So this diagnosis is made in case of fever. So subjective data, patient may have fever, sore throat because of infection, shortness of breath, nasal congestion, so this all infection. And when the fever is very high, patient may feel dryness, on foul smelling thick sputum. So this all the patient may complain. And in objective data, you can touch the person, he may be warm, and temperature may be more than 98.6 degree Fahrenheit, and sputum analysis in that color consistency and the culture will be done in order to identify if there is infection, and respiratory rate, it can be increased or decreased according to the fever and according to the condition, and heart rate will be increased. So any condition with fever can increase the heart rate also. And chest x-ray reveals consolidation and patches in the lungs, which means infected areas you can see in the lung. And patient may have a surgical incision or a tracheostomy procedure or intercostal drainage procedure. So anytime when the first line of protection is the skin, when the skin is cut, the any microorganism can enter and cause infection. So these are all the objective data you can see. And our goal is to maintain a normal body temperature. So we have to reduce the temperature. Intervention done is, first we have to monitor vital signs. So you can identify baseline data and what is the fever and why cause of fever. And adequate ventilation of environment. So when you provide ventilation by switching on fan or any AC, then the heat loss can be there by convection. Convection is heat loss through air current. And hot compressors or tepid sponging will promote heat loss by conduction. So when conduction is, the body heat will go in the sponge. And suction as needed so that it can relieve the infected secretions. And strict aseptic technique whenever you do any procedure on the patient so that it can prevent cross infection. And sterile dressing to all the surgical site in case of tracheostomy, tracheostomy area, in case of thoracentesis or intercostal drainage system, any system, you have to maintain sterile aseptic technique so to avoid infection. And nebulizer therapy, so our with steroids, again this will liquefy the secretion and remove the thick foul smelling sputum. And chest physiotherapy and breathing cuffing exercise, these all will remove the secretions by mobilizing from the lower respiratory tract. And tell the patient to take more of oral fluids and fruit juices, so this can again reduce temperature. And antipyretics in case of fever and antibiotics to treat the infection. So the evaluation may be client maintained normal body temperature. The next diagnosis is activity intolerance related to decreased tissue oxygenation secondary to bronchial obstruction or any invasive procedures. Okay, so whenever there is decreased oxygen to the tissues, tissues will become fatigue and patient cannot do activity. And also if there is any invasive procedures like any surgical procedure or tracheostomy or any procedure, patient may have difficulty in doing activity. So in subjective data, you can see patient having breathlessness during activity, decreased exercise tolerance, that is patient cannot do exercise at a stretch, and inability to perform activities of daily living. So chest tightness, labored breathing during activity. So this all the patient will complain. And in objective data, you can see dyspnea, that is patient is feeling difficulty whenever he is doing activity. And accessory muscles of breathing, so that is you can see the neck muscles and also diaphragmatic muscles are going up and down as patient is labored breathing. And decreased muscle tone, so this is because the muscles have become fatigued due to lack of oxygen, muscle tone will be decreased. And oxygen saturation levels will be decreased again because tissues are not getting oxygenation. And ABG also shows decreased oxygenation of blood. And cyanosis, this is bluish discoloration of the skin due to lack of oxygen in blood. And patient may undergo a surgery or a tracheostomy procedure or intercostal drainage. So because of any of these procedures, he may not able to perform his activity. So our goal is to increase the tolerance of client to activity. And we'll monitor the vital signs to and the ability to perform activities. So we have to see how much patient is able to perform. Again, Fowler's positioning, so this will give extra space for the oxygen for the lungs so that oxygen can go inside, and oxygen therapy for artificial respiration, and adequate periods between rest periods between activity. So whenever patient is having breathing difficulty, you have to tell them to rest, and other time you can do activity, and you have to provide assistance in doing all the daily activities so that he can meet the hygiene. And teach and practice mild exercise on bed when the client is breathing normally. So when he's normal, you have to tell him to practice mild activity so that it will prevent spasticity of the extremities and thereby he can improve the activity. And you have to
teach about pulmonary rehabilitation measures. So these pulmonary rehabilitation already I have taught, like exercise, nutrition, lifestyle activities and the medications. So everything I have to teach them so that patient can improve his activity. And medications like steroids, bronchodilators, anticholinergics, antibiotics. So these all as prescription you have to administer so that patient will improve their breathing pattern. Thereby there will be oxygenation to the tissues and patient can increase the tolerance level of activity. And provide care to the surgical site. Okay, so whenever patient is having any surgery, you have to see the dressing, everything is done properly, so that the wound will heal faster, so that person can perform the activity by himself. So in evaluation, you have to see whether the client's tolerance to activity was improved, so that the person may do the activities without difficulty. Okay, the final diagnosis is ineffective therapeutic regimen management related to chronicity of the disease and its prognosis. Okay, because patient is having chronic condition, he may need to follow the therapeutic management at home. And also the until the prognosis is improved, he has to follow all the activities. So we made this diagnosis. So subjective data, you can see breathlessness, dyspnea, and patient age may be increased and the disease is chronic and also can be a communicable disease like tuberculosis. And in objective data, so there may be lack of awareness about the disease prognosis. Patient needs some lifestyle changes. So because of the chronic condition and need for education related to the disease condition, so patient may be unaware about the health condition, so you have to educate them, and need for home care management. So because it is a chronic condition and patient may go with an oxygen or a nebulizer therapy to home, so we have to teach the patient about how to maintain all this at home. So the objective is to maintain the health status by following all the healthcare and therapeutic activities. And intervention is you have to assess the clients and significant others, means those caregiving to the client or the family members, about their ability to understand instructions. So that means in which language the person is able to understand, in that language we have to give them knowledge. And about all the home management of oxygen therapy, nebulizer therapy, inhaler therapy, how it has to be used, and where he can get the oxygen therapy when the oxygen is finished. So all those things you have to teach the person. Even nebulizer therapy and inhaler therapy, correct technique has to be taught so that he will follow at home. And teach about pulmonary rehabilitation measures. So as I already said, what age, what nutrition. So in case of weight loss, you have to tell the person increase protein. In case of weight gain, you have to tell them to do some mild exercise and reduce the weight. So like that, according to the patient needs, we have to teach the rehabilitation therapies. And you have to schedule activities with adequate rest periods. Okay, so tell the patient to take adequate rest and in between do some mild activities so that spasticity can be prevented, and this will also increase the activity tolerance. And nutritional management as per the nutritional needs, that is, as I already said, reduce weight in case of obesity, and in case of weight loss, you have to advise the patient to take more of protein. So these will meet the metabolic needs of the patient, and educate about all the pharmacological management, their drugs, their dose, their action side effects, and the need for lifelong therapy. So everything should be taught so that patient can take according as advised at home. And also thereby it will improve the respiratory function. And educate the need for isolation techniques in case of communicable disease like TB or COVID-19. So you have to tell the patient strictly to follow all the isolation practices, hand hygiene practices, universal precautions. Everything should be taught so that infection can be prevented at home, and reassurance psychological support has to be provided, and also inform the patient when he has to come for a follow-up. So all those education should be provided so that patient. So in evaluation, you can see patient is able to maintain therapeutic activities as evidenced by safe home care management. The patient can also have pleuritic chest pain related to inflammatory process of the airways causing bronchoconstriction and reduce airflow to the lungs. Okay, so in this patient will have dyspnea, complain of sore throat, chest pain, tight chest tightness, labored breathing, and he may also say yes, a generalized body ache. So in objective data, you can see painful facial grimaces, use of accessory muscles for breathing, and air hunger and gasping for breaths. And pain score you can identify is increased. Chest X-ray will reveal pulmonary infiltrates and lung consolidation, which means there is some irritation or injury within the lungs. And other than this, in case of patient have any chest trauma, any chest surgeries, so everything can cause pain. So pleuritic chest pain related to inflammatory process of the airways causing bronchoconstriction and reduce airflow to the lungs. So goal is to relieve pain and ease the effort of breathing. And in this interventions are, you have to monitor vital signs so that you can, and also pain score so that you can identify the severity and quality of pain. And Fowler's positioning, again it will give enough space for breathing. And oxygen therapy so that it will aid in respiration so that it can minimize the pain. And comfort devices like pillows or cardiac tables so the patient can rest on it and he can just take a nap. And adequate rest, so in when rest patient oxygen utilization is decreased so that patient will have relief from pain. And diversional therapy like light music or any songs or anything according to the patient interest, you have to divert the mind of the person. And analgesics like morphine or any analgesics as prescribed to relieve pain. And bronchodilators, again they will increase the airway passage and thereby patient will have ease in breathing so that pain can be relieved. And warm showers or baths can be given in case patient is having a generalized body ache and fatigue, then you can give warm showers bath so that patient will have some soothing effect. And heat also increases vasodilation so that they can relieve the pain. And reassurance and psychological support so that patient will relieve the anxiety and also it can reduce the pain. So in evaluation you can see client experience reduced pain as evidenced by improved breathing pattern. That's all about nursing diagnosis, and according to the patient condition, so some may you can add or delete the nursing care plan. And thanks for watching. Please share, subscribe if you are interested.